Good evening, everyone. My name is Heath Haskins, Code Primate, and this is Let's Play Lumber Tycoon 2 with Sam and DarkJ. What's up, DarkJ?
What's up, man? How you doing?
Pretty good, pretty good. So, I've got this checkerboard here, and I need to get somebody to play it with. You want to play some checkers?
Oh, yeah, man. This brings me back to olden days, the days of old.
Uh-oh. I got a problem.
What?
I'm not whitelisted. There we go.
Oh, hold on. There you go. Sweet. All whitelisted.
All right, so rules are simple. Game of checkers. You must take your jumps if the jump is possible. I will be red, you will be brown.
Sounds good.
So before there's smoke, there's fire, right? So red moves first? Is that right?
Yeah. It is your game. You you play first.
Don't forget to press E when picking up a piece, so make sure that you have ownership. And go.
All right. Oh, man. Here we go.
It's been so long.
Moment of truth. Ah! I can't even center it right in the middle. There we go.
And I'll move that one right there. Okay, your turn.
Where should I move?
Give you guys like an oversight view of what's going on. The whole view of the board.
There we go.
Nice. And that is a jump. I have to take it. Jump.
Yes.
Boink. And, E. There we go. And discard pile right there. Boom.
All right. So, I just because I want to be the first person to do it.
I see what you did there.
Double
one jump. And two. Nicely done, sir. Nicely done.
Oh, yeah. Give me them red pieces.
But little did he know, he didn't see the double jump on the opposite side.
Go boom. I opened up a double jump. Oh, no. My pretty brown pieces. Because brown is so pretty.
It's the prettiest color. Yeah, of all the colors, the brown.
It's magnificent. All right, take red piece out of here.
No, you'll never take us all.
You'll never take us alive.
I'll do that one. Kind of set up my front line here. Get back into defensive position. Okay.
Ooh, he's getting defensive. Where should I move?
By the way, I've messaged Defaultio like 20 times. I'm like, chess pieces, dude. Come on. I need some chess pieces.
That would be amazing. Chess pieces for the win.
Yeah, but knowing him, I'd have to like decipher 128-bit hexadecimal encryption with some kind of thing just to get to him, so
you know, it'd be hidden on some crazy part of the map that every single segment of the map would have a key piece to it. And then all of a sudden we'd find one piece and we'd be like, oh, that's just the rook, where's the rest?
we'll just play with rooks for now. Let's just go rooks.
5 months from now, we have half the chess set. That's only the white pieces.
Thank you guys for watching episode 373.
We finally were able to make one move.
Ooh, he's coming up on me. He's coming up. He's gonna go that way, isn't he? He's gonna go right there. I knew it. I called it.
Yes.
Okay. I like what's happening here. Let's do this. Like that. Uh-oh, I don't like that. That was not good on my part. Oh,
a gosh. Forward advance.
And let's go ahead and sneak him on around there like that. Got it.
Code Prime, inches closer. Who will be the victor in this match of wits?
I just want to get a king so I can try and stack two of these things. Oh, man. Okay. If I go to the right, I'm going to get jumped. If I go to the left, he's got to move, and I'll get a jump next round. So we'll go this way. All right. So I'm set up to get the first king. Power play by DarkJ.
Although you're definitely going to get the first king.
Just going to sneak it in there too. Ooh.
I'm like over here on pins and needles, like, where's he gonna move next? Anticipating.
You can't stand on the piece where I'm trying to put it. It's like, don't put it here! Don't look over here. Wait, okay, you're crowning them. That is the rule. Like, you have to crown the other person that gets the king.
Yep.
Son, king me!
Okay, where to move? Where to move? Oh, man. Where to move? Well, I've got to move this guy out of here because... Oh, he's your only path to freedom with that king. Oh, man. I'm definitely going to lose this guy, though. Oh, what do I do? What do I do? Oh, that is definitely a sticky, sticky situation. Well, I guess better sacrifice that piece.
Oh. And if you... Okay, I have to take the jump. Okay. All right. I'll take the piece. It's cool. Oh, whoa, Mr. Wiggly. Hold on. Forgot to press E on it. All right. Oh. You know that unprotects this one down here, too, right?
Yes.
Psst, DarkJ. Right here, dude. Look.
Psst. Yeah, but... Oh, man. Man, this is, you put me in a rock and a hard place here, man. That's, Oh no. This is where the balance gets tipped into Code Prime's favor. Oh no. It's been so long.
Do I get a home field advantage? Just kidding. Sorry. That's sports talk, guys. Sorry. I don't talk sports.
Not at all. Nah, that one's done anyway.
But that clears you up to get a king in there. Boom. Grab E. Like that. The other thing that forcing jumps does, it takes away my move. So if I had something strategic planned out, like he just took that away from me. So.
That is right. Looking to the future, however, I'm still significantly less pieces. There is that.
Kinda. Like, you don't really have a huge disadvantage. Okay, I'm kidding. I'm just trying to make you feel better.
Yeah, yeah. Two less pieces and one of those pieces being a king. That's Oh, man.
Wait, did you go? Hold on. No, you didn't go yet.
That's right, because you jumped me.
Here's a safe move right here, just saying.
Nope. Not moving there. I know what you're trying to do. I know what you want. That king is plastered there for now.
I'm just saying, sacrificing
a piece.
My king can only move as fast as your pieces do. Just saying.
Yes, but it can move in any direction, making double, triple, and quadruple jumps very possible.
I think I've only done a triple jump like twice in my entire lifetime. And that was whenever I landed king, got the king, and then next move was a triple.
Yeah, I have actually gotten a quadruple jump, and I was playing it was either my mom or my sister, I can't remember, it was so long ago, and it was almost like perfectly laid out, and I had just gotten kinged, and it was perfect. It was like four jumps right in a row. They got so mad.
There we go. I'm gonna try and get up there and wedge in between you, force you to jump out.
I don't think you're supposed to tell me your battle strategy.
Nah, it's okay. It's cool. I'm gonna win.
it's all cool. I mean, you know.
So I got the confidence going for me.
the confidence thing is definitely there.
Alright, you can't.
Although
jump
I probably am going. Oh. Oh, did you just? Did you?
I did. I did.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you so much.
All right, I'll make this a little interesting. All right. Let's go ahead and force you out of that corner. There you go. That means you're not going to be able to get your king this turn.
No.
Then let's go ahead and start moving that king out. Boink.
Ooh, you went that way.
Boink. You want your king. You want your king. Strategically and logistically speaking, you want your king. So I'm just waiting.
He said, I'm just waiting. I'm just waiting. Oh, man. Crud.
You could go here, or you could go here, and no need to look over here for any reason at all. Don't look over there.
I moved.
Hover. Oh, you moved already. Oh, well, okay. I'll just leave that there for next turn.
Nope, you got a force jump.
Oh, what?
You gotta jump me.
No! You're gonna take my king. No! Hello. Well, that was fun.
Sacrifice for the greater good.
Did you see what just happened there?
Was
I the only one that caught that? That was awesome.
What happened?
Okay, so I took your piece and I had to move it off, but I forgot to press E on it. So it like glitched forward, glitched back, hit me in the feet, and threw me like 50 feet up in the air. I'm like, oh, that was fun. Landed, and I still had grip of the piece.
So. Nice.
That was
like
cool.
That time that I was helping clean your base and that fire axe went into space.
Just disappeared.
And then, like, was it like 15, 20 minutes later? You're like, oh, hey, here's that fire axe right here. I'm like, wait, how the heck?
The big platform on top.
Yeah, that was awesome.
20 minutes later, it falls down. Hey, there it is. Okay, I moved. Get an overview of the board as it seems from my side.
I believe it is time to get that king now. Ooh, ooh, king me, king me, king me.
You got it. Press E. And voila. King.
All right.
Let's go. No, I don't want to be forced, so let's go here. Thank you. We both now have kings. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 pieces versus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pieces. Each with a king. Ooh.
My king is very, very rustic, you know, brown looking, you know. Where to go?
Locked in an epic battle of checkers. Boop.
Oh no. Okay, well, I guess that just means less pieces on the board.
That one goes bye-bye, and boop. That one goes bye-bye.
My pretty brown peas. No. Okay.
Strategies. Strategical thinking. One, two.
Buckle my shoe. Three, four. Close the door.
Okay, so
no memories.
Oh yeah. 5, 6, pick up sticks, 7, 8, lay them straight. I was playing lumber in elementary school.
That's right. See? Born to play this. It all led up to this moment right here, this epic battle of checkers.
All the years of elementary and college have paid off for this single moment.
This one epic moment.
There we go.
And you get to view it right here.
Okay, I moved. Oh no, he's gonna chase me up the board. Oh, run, little guy, run.
He's like, run as fast as your legs can take you.
Stop hopping, flip up on the side and roll. All right, so that's good because he is now safe in the corner, but my other little piece, he's going to be dancing. Whoa, run, little guy. And I'm going
to... And it's an epic chase.
I'm going to peel him off right here. There we go.
All right.
Ooh.
Ooh, this is getting intense, man. It's heating up.
There we go. Okay, I'm good. Quick overview of the board and what it looks like. I'm about to get my second king. Gonna get my second king.
You gonna get his second king? Oh no.
We got two kings. Two kings on the board. No. Boom. King May.
Oh, snap. Oh, snap.
By the way, this is really fun.
Yes, it is. This is like I said, it takes me back to the olden days of childhood fun memories, which is awesome.
I can't force jump either one of those. Ooh. And you're just going to have this straight shot through here, aren't you?
Mm-hmm.
he's like, yeah, that's what my plan was.
From the very beginning.
All right, let's see here. Let's go ahead and start in on the third king.
Three kings, Arabian Night. Oh.
Force jump. Wait, no, wrong one. What? No, you were supposed to... No.
Thank you.
You're supposed to jump with this one.
I appreciate you jump, your patronage.
You jump here, and then I go to boom, to boom, and I get to double. Wait, what just happened? And that's when code knew. I won't say the rest of that meme. Just saying. Okay, go. No, he's got a king. He's got a king on the board.
King me.
And your king, sir.
Beautiful crown.
Boom.
Oh, yes.
Yep. One more. Let's do this.
Oh, man. Intense. Two players locked in a heated battle.
And I'm like, I don't want to move either one of those guys out of that spot. Okay, let's go ahead and do the king thing first.
Wait.
I shall king you, sir.
Nice.
Three kings.
I just realized this goes on too long. We're at like 22 minutes right now.
We could have an hour long episode next time on Semper Life and DarkJ Gaming. We will be about one quarter of the way through the match of checkers, the longest match ever played.
did you go? You did go.
No, I did. Oh. I did not go. I need to think hard about this one. There we go.
I'm actually, like, I know it was a lot of work, but I'm really glad I made it out of the countertops.
Yeah, I was gonna ask about the grayish texture. Which wood did you actually use for that?
Birch, actually.
Ooh,
birch nice. Turned out to be a really nice color for this.
Yeah, because it naturally adds like the blackish, right? And then so you had white wood. That's awesome. So I gotta be really careful here because anything I do could result in a double or triple jump against me if I don't do it correctly.
Ooh.
All right.
There we go. Notice I get real quiet when I get strategic. Do you feel the intensity in the air? Could cut it with DarkJ's wing.
I feel it.
Could cut it with DarkJ's wing, the intensity.
Whoa, that one was going nuts.
Nice.
Although, at the same time, It could pin that one against the wall forever.
No stalemates. Let's make that rule.
Okay.
I've done that before where you're like, you move forward, you move back, you move forward, you move back, and nobody ever moves anywhere.
Okay, that guy is stuck. Like Chuck. Let's move. Start to move out the other king.
Alright, boys, roll out!
Roll out! Autobots, roll out!
Wait, what?
Autobots, roll out. Alright, this one's dead. So I'm gonna move him there. He's dead. Come get your king.
A third king!
Boom! And you know what? Let's not play with that one anymore. I'm done with that one. There we go. Yeah, I'll just get this one set up down here because I know that's where you're going next. So, okay, let me know when you got that one killed. Okay, cool. And we're gonna start moving this one down here. Oh, come on. There we go. Oh, that one's still yours. There we go. No, it's mine. And just get on there. Perfect. Good. Okay. Your turn.
Nice. You know what would be awesome is if we could figure out how to make a Jenga setup.
Oh, we tried Jenga with what was it? Beta boxes. Like I had an entire setup, and after about 5 or 6 stacks, stuff just goes crazy. It starts glitching out like crazy.
I can imagine.
There is no holding them back.
Oh man.
You're just gonna sit on this one, aren't you? Like this little guy right here?
Yeah, as long as I can. It limits your movement.
There we go.
And as long as I am a pain in your butt, that is always what matters. There we go.
King Mister.
Be sure to press E before you move it.
Oh yeah, I'll send like half the piece flying into the abyss.
Rage quit, table flip on the Lumber Tycoon 2 chessboard.
you didn't build in a whole table flip feature?
That would be awesome. Put hinges underneath every single tile.
End game.
Table flip
lever. Yes.
Pushes all the pieces off. Okay, your turn.
Right.
I've lined up in the strategic eye formation.
The strategic eye. Oh no. Okay.
By the way, the strategic eye formation is the most commonly known to get triple jumped. Ooh. Okay, so he's following the battle there. Let's go this direction. And
good. He's breaking the eye formation. Where shall they go now?
Perfect, he's falling right into my trap. There we go. Now, if I get a king back to the other side, can I split it in two?
I don't think it works that way.
I don't think that's a rule. That'd be fun, though.
Yeah.
Knight Rider.
Da 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 da.
Oh, what's he doing? What's he doing? Oh, uh-oh. Uh-oh, what have you done? What have you done? Oh, dear. There we go. Okay, go.
Hmm.
What was that?
That would be time. That's it's time to wake up, man. It's my alarm. It's a rooster on my. I keep one in my kitchen. Don't ask questions. Just roll with it.
That's cool. Some people have alarm clocks. You got a chicken?
Exactly.
Boom. Moving in for the kill. Look at this. Oh, snap.
I knew it was going to happen. Just like that.
See? Eye formation. Huh? I have no clue what I'm talking about.
That strategic eye formation started all of this. Put it into motion. Well, I could. Okay.
What? So that is a forced jump on my part, isn't it? Oh, snap. Oh, come here. Whoa. Lag, stalemate. There we go. Okay. There we go.
I was really hoping that you would have jumped one of these kings instead of that one. When plans don't go as according to something just, like that.
Just a reminder. Remember when that brown piece came right through here? Uh-huh. And I was like, here, look, force move. And I was trying to get you to jump this direction. Yeah, just saying. Payback.
Karma. I was hoping you weren't, or you were paying more attention to the pieces at hand. Like, I saw it, but I was like, nah, he's going to jump one of my kings for sure. That's what's going to happen. He's going to want that king.
Well,
the
king's a given. I'm going to get a king. There we go. I got a guaranteed king or an extra little brown up there. I got him. Oh, forgot to hit E on those again.
Oh, no.
There we go. Got it.
Yeah, I was so hoping to trade a king for a king. Oh, wow. We are down to three kings against three kings.
3-on-3.
Oh, no. Tie game, folks. Tie game.
Logistically speaking, now that I think about it, we would go 1-for-1 all the way up until we finally stalemated. Do you want to call it on this one? We're definitely going to need like some chess pieces or something.
You know what? Let's settle this with a game of that tic-tac-toe. The winner of that tic-tac-toe is the winner today.
Sounds like a plan. Let's do it.
All right.
Do you want alphas or betas?
You know what? I'm feeling lucky. I'm going to go with alphas. That's right. It kind of matches my headphones too, man. You know.
That's true. Gotta go with your colors. I'm not really a blue person. I'm more of a purple, but purple and blue, they're close enough. So, go ahead.
Hold on. Yeah. Do I gotta empty my inventory here?
Yes, my plan is working.
Don't log off.
Quick, leave game. Just kidding.
No.
You've got one. All right, hold on. Let's get that back over there. There you go. Okay. Now leave game.
You had to put it right in the perfect spot.
Seeing as I went first on checkers, I'll let you go first on alphas. Or on tic-tac alpha.
On Tic-Tac Alpha? Alright.
I'll play your game.
Make sure my pieces are back on, just in case I do get logged off. I don't want to lose all my checkers. There we go.
Alright, there we go.
All right, he chooses top right. I'm gonna go left middle. Boom.
Hmm.
Hmm?
There we go.
Oh, I see what you did there. Oh, he's won. He won. All right, see what he's doing. Hold on.
The only place that kind of screws up my plans.
You were going to go here, and then you have your two places like that, and then, yeah, but that's not going to work, because I got to go here. Wait, what is that? That's not a... Wait.
End times X. Out of nowhere.
End times X is like a wild card on tic-tac-toe. You don't know whose it is. There we go.
Oh, this might end up being cat.
Oh. Oh, I didn't see that move up there, did I? That was I totally didn't see it. Oh no. I'm gonna win next round. I'm gonna win. I'm gonna win. Oh no! DarkJ, you got tic tac toe.
Yeah, tic tac toe. Hooray. He said I totally didn't see that move.
totally didn't see it. That was out of nowhere.
That's right. That's right, I claim victory!
Alright, let's get lined up on the board here. Line up, face that direction. Or that board, this board, there we go.
This board.
Thank you everyone for watching this episode of Let's Play Lumber Tycoon 2 with me, Heath Haskins, Code Primate, playing a Semper Life, along with DarkJ. What's up, man?
What's up, guys? Thank you for watching. It's been awesome.
Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe down below. No pressure from me to do so. DarkJ might pressure you a little bit, but that's okay. We love you guys. Have a great night. Bye.
Do it or else.
See, I told you.
Stay awesome.
I told you.